Great, thank you so much, Sam. So this being my third Vatican Youth Symposium, it is hard not to look back in reflection and smile at the memory of everything that has transpired both within and outside of this room. So from meeting people who would become some of my closest friends and mentors, to undergoing personal growth in unexpected ways and wonderful ways, to, of course, Dr. Annette's infamous rapping of Hamilton before the assembly, we have all shared so much together over these 3 years. For the third time, I'm sitting here in awe of all of the knowledge, inspiration, and expertise the people in this room have to offer. I have witnessed from the 2016 symposium to today, fellow delegates run for US Congress, challenge a dictator for liberal democratic reforms, lead campaigns for the well-being of sex trafficking victims, establish sustainable development solutions organizations, and petition for greater refugee protections. And this is just the tipping point of what we as past symposium participants have accomplished in 3 years. I myself was so inspired by the speeches of survivors at the 2016 symposium that I decided to join an anti-sex trafficking organization called Red Light at Emory upon my return from Rome 2 years ago. I am now one of the co-presidents of that organization, and it has grown into one of the most successful student bodies on Emory University's campus. And like many of last year's participants, I am fortunate enough to have continued our work on the 2030 Today initiative to create a platform for SDG action plans in coordination with some of the largest organizations and institutions in the world. And finally, as an outcome of last year's symposium, and a call to action for the present one, I am helping SDSN youth to lead a series of workshops on Laudato Si and the Sustainable Development Goals for the 2019 World Youth Day celebrations in Panama. It is clear from my experience and that of any other delegate that has passed through this hall that when the world invests in young people, as you have invested in this symposium, young people will take the reins and lead the way. The only illusion is that this is a novel observation, for in truth, the newness and creativity of ideas has always and will always drive a renewed commitment towards positive change. We need one another. We need to hear and listen to the people in this room, and we need those who disagree with us too. We need each other in the largest sense imaginable, because even if we cannot agree, we need to be able to understand. So long as there is the human condition, so long as we are free to err or to flourish, we are capable of change. And right now we are confronted with not one option or two for the future, but many. We are not at a fork in the road. We are facing infinite potential pathways and trying to find the right one to choose. But at the end of the day, at the end of today, it is not the path that will determine our future. It is how we live our lives along that path. Those of us sitting in this room are not immune to making mistakes. There's a high likelihood that even we as leaders may make a mistake, misjudge a situation, or fail to understand the ends of our actions. And again, this leadership, this moral leadership, will be defined by our ability to recognize our failure and find a way to rise again. Our strength will not come from any superior ability to discern, but from a perseverance to strive for a better world, no matter the harsh challenges we face. Because as global challenges mount and the pressure to give up hope for a better world heightens, there will be more noise abrading our minds, more confusion clouding our judgment, and more chaos overwhelming our hearts. For reason and faith to prevail, for our optimistic dreams of youth to be realized, the talents of all disciplines will be required. We need scientists to enlighten us on our ecological trajectory. We need engineers to craft solutions to our infrastructure gaps. We need economists to strategize pathways for efficient and ethical resource allocation in the modern political world. We need philosophers to share guiding frameworks for moral leadership with each generation. And the list goes on and on. I am reminded of the necessity for the accord between philosophy and faith, as was best defended by Pope St. John Paul II in his 1998 encyclical Fides et Ratio. In it, he stated that, quote, "Deprived of reason, faith has stressed feeling and experience, and so run the risk of no longer being a universal proposition. It is an illusion to think that faith, tied to weak reasoning, might be more penetrating. On the contrary, faith then runs the grave risk of withering into myth or superstition. By the same token, reason which is unrelated to an adult faith is not prompted to turn its gaze to the newness and radicality of being. The pharisia of faith must be matched by the boldness of reason." In this space, here in Casina Pio Corto, a place where scientists, philosophers, and religious leaders have gathered together in a historic and a contemporary sense. I have never felt so deeply a call to renew our joint convictions across all of our disciplines to use knowledge for the benefit of humanity. For as much as there are reasons to see the world as succumbing to chaos, there is a singular, greater reason to have faith in our future. That is, the tangible spirit of hope and optimism in this room and that exists on behalf of all of the groups, backgrounds, and countries that we represent. What must remain as the very temporary chaos in our world subsides is principled, courageous leadership and an unwillingness to compromise our most sanctimonious values. John Keats may have said it best in his concluding stanza of Ode on Aggression Urn in 1819. When old age shall this generation waste, thou shalt remain in midst of other woe, than ours a friend to man to whom thou sayest, beauty is truth, truth beauty. That is all ye know on earth and all ye need to know. Indeed, if we strive for truth through our faith and beauty through our wisdom, there is nothing more we need to know other than what are we waiting for? Thank you.